Welcome to my video using Microsoft Dynamics Nav to complete a consumption journal entry. What we're going to do is we'll use the consumption journal to decrease our on-hand inventory for our bill of material items, which will put the quantity into the production order as well as put the cost into the production order. So when I open up Microsoft Dynamics Nav, if I don't already have the consumption journal in my ribbon, or on my navigation pane, I can use my trusty search to type in the consumption journal, and then it brings me to my journal page. So this looks very similar to the output journal or the item journal or any of the other journals that you may use in Nav. And in this field, in these fields, I could choose to enter in the posting date, the release production order number, I could indicate the item that was consumed on the bill of material, and all the pertinent information, and then post. But the consumption journal has a really handy little button up in the ribbon called Calculate Consumption. And when I select that, it will look and I have the ability to enter in the production order that I'm interested in. Or I could leave it blank, or I could use my dot dot to use my range, or I could use my pipe to use my or and select multiple production orders. I can indicate the calculation based on what the actual output is or expected output, and of course that looks at the expected quantity based on my quantity per and my production order quantities, and it will actually fill in for me a quantity already, which I could then choose to accept or I could choose to manipulate and change if I needed to. So now this journal has populated with all the information that I needed. So it's looking at, I need rims, I need spokes, I need the front hub, the tire, the tube, and it's indicated the quantity. Now if, say for example, production came back to me and they said I didn't use 11, I had to use 12 rims, or I had to use, 555 spokes because I lost a few, or there was a little bit of damage done. That's fine, I can change the quantity if I need to. I can increase the quantity it told me, I can decrease the quantity it told me, and again, I can always just accept what was given to me as well. What I could also do if I need to is I could enter in any lot or serial information that may be required when I'm consuming my materials. So in the example that I have here, under the spokes, I know I need to indicate the lot that those spokes came into. So I can come up to my item tracking lines from my ribbon. I select item tracking lines, which opens up my item tracking lines page. I could indicate the lot. I can indicate how many came in on the lot. So say for example, if 500 were on the first lot, and then there was a second lot where I needed the additional 55 pieces, I can indicate that there. So you'll notice before I tab off this field that the item needs 555 lines defined. Currently on the first line, I only have 500, so 55 are undefined. As soon as I tab off that field, you'll notice that nothing is undefined, which is the ultimate goal, because if the item is set up, you may need to track for every single quantity in that, and we don't want to have anything that doesn't have a quantity. So we say okay. Once I am done, I can come up to the ribbon and I can select to post. It will ask me if I want to post the journal line. So if I'm okay with the quantities, I'm okay with where they're going, I'm okay with the unit amounts, then I can say okay to. And what that does is it clears the journal so that I have decreased all my on-hand inventories for the quantity components. I've issued cost into the production order so that we can view that in the statistics. My item journal entries are done, or my item ledger entries, sorry, are completed, and I have now consumed material into the job, and it's no longer available to be used on other jobs. Thank you for watching my video using the consumption journal in Microsoft Dynamics Nav.